All right, welcome back to my channel. Welcome, good morning, YouTubers, refiners, scrappers, and electronic waste recovery experts. Today, I'm just gonna go over what I've done this week and start sorting, and we will start processing soon. These were pins that I have pulled off of the CD-ROMs I had started on this week while watching TV. Look, I just use a pair of clines and pinch those things. These will probably be put in AP and let them sit for a couple of months to go after the base metals and the foils. I find that to be the most economical method. And after that, I go further processing with hydrochloric acid and bleach, and we'll drop it with either SMB or ferrous sulfate. I like the ferrous sulfate. It doesn't stink, I'm not going to lie. So this is the gold that I recovered the last couple of weeks, and I need to sort it. So we've got pins in here, we've got fenders, and stuff that I need to sort so that we can process properly. And what I'll do is I'll sort it like this goes into my pile of, I don't know what you call that, gold ribbon cable, okay? So the ribbon cable will be separated. The gold-plated pins will be cleaned up a little bit more, and then we will treat that in acid peroxide real soon. Stay tuned, because I'll be restarting that silver cell to go after, use up that electrolyte, and I feel like we're going to grow a little bit bigger crystals with a 2-liter. So that's coming up next. So we're going to sort this real quick and then get back to it, okay? I just want to go over this. Y'all don't tell my wife, but I took her Target clock that never held time. I had to replace the batteries on that like every 6 weeks. I hated that thing. I don't think she knows it's missing. But this was on the back of it. It's pretty nice, man. It had little push buttons for the hour. And that thing's like 10, 15 years old. I think it's even older. And I hated that thing. She doesn't know it's gone yet. All right. This stuff came from my laptops that my father-in-law gave me, and some recent pickups that are, you know, just ordinary e-waste. So what I did was I separate into a couple of piles. This is obviously needs further processing. These, if they don't have wire on them, I feel like I'm safe enough to run them through acid peroxide. But I think prior to that, I'm going to dunk them in some hydrochloric acid for a couple of days to go after the solder that's on that, and then run it through AP. I feel like that's probably the best to attack base metals in the tin, and then I can run it through AP solution and let it go slowly. So we've got some pins there that will go in here. These will need to be processed a little farther before I can put them in here. And this was the, you know, little gold finger cards that I will run through a batch of AP acid peroxide chlorate etchant. And I'm thinking that I might cut these tips off right here and run that with these and then just incinerate this piece later. I feel like that's probably a good bet to get to that real thin gold. So I've got to add it to this pile, and I have some RAM cards that I want to attack real quick, but that's it for the recovery. And I think I'm going to start this in some AP today. And don't forget, we have that silver cell coming up. All right, so next what I'm going to do is go through these old RAM sticks and cut these fingers off and then add them to the pile. Probably going to add these too, I'm not going to lie. They're ceramic, they look video chips that I feel like I can run through the AP, get the gold plating off, and then crush them. Oh, maybe crush them to get to the gold inside there. That's probably a good idea. Crush them a little to crack to get to that stuff. You can see here, there's still a little bit of gold on that, so maybe that's a good option. I think I'm going to keep these. Now, I know they're older. These are a memory cards, and this is a 4 gigabyte. And just to show you how far we've come along, this is 64 megabytes little RAM sticks. But I don't feel like I can safely take these off. I don't know. I'll hold on to these. You know, if somebody wants these, holler and I can hook them up for anybody for the vintage. So maybe I'll just hold on to these and we'll process these for all the computer people out there that say, my God, you need to save these. Look, man, I'm an electronic scrapper. Not a lot of saving. I don't send stuff to board sorts because I don't have the time to sort, and I'm in the gold refining, not the computer sending boards off to people business. So we're going to process these. We're going to put them in here. We'll end up in that pile, and I have a whole bunch of ribbon I want to trim up and put in that. So we'll have a better look at what we're going to process in AP real soon. We're going to do a couple of these.
Keeps going in and out of focus.
Let's just shot across. Finish it up.
Go ahead.
So we're going to add these gold fingers to the acid peroxide today and let that sit for a couple of weeks and then come back. So these bags are going to go into this container. I'll put the AP in there and we'll come back in a couple seconds. All right, so here it is all tucked away. I got to tell you something, it's not as green looking as it was in that bucket, but I'll bubble it in a couple of days. We're going to roll with it. May have a little bit of iron chloride in it, but that's going to attack. This is really known as copper 2 etchant, and what it does is it attacks the base metals under those foils. So that's what I'm hoping it's going to do. If I have real slow reaction, I'll bubble it up, but we're going to let that sit for a little while.